All right, guys, so we've already learned about installing and using Python within macOS and Linux. The two operating systems actually have a very similar process, and that's because they're both derived from the Unix operating system, where Windows is not. So Windows is a little bit different, so I'm going to walk you guys through this right now. You need to go to python.org. Once you get to python.org, you need to hover over Downloads here in the main menu, and then find Windows here. It should also be defaulted to Windows if you're on Windows. So we're going to be choosing which version we're going to be using, and we are always going to be using Python 3x, not 2. So ignore Python 2 right there. Click Python 3.6.1, and it's going to download the installer for you. Now, when this is done downloading, we can install it. So just launch the program. And let me just uninstall this first so that I can reinstall it. Redownload that. While this is uninstalling, we're going to be talking about the environment variables and why you need them. And when I installed Python on Windows a while back, there was a problem with the path, or maybe not the path, but specifically the Python installer package, which we're going to be discussing. And if you guys do have the problem that I had, it's going to be terrible, but there's an easy workaround for it. All right, so let's close that and then run the Python 3.6 installer. Now, there's one very important thing that we need to do, and that is you need to check add Python 3.6 to path, and then click install now. Now, while that's doing that, I'm going to search for control panel here. And in the control panel, let's go into system. If you don't see this view, right-click up here and select small icons. This should work on Windows 7, 8, or 10, and everybody should be on one of those operating systems anyway, because Vista might not be end of life yet. Vista, it was either April or May that was happening, and it is April now. So anyway, if you're on Windows 7, 8, or 10, go to System, and on the left-hand side, click Advanced System Settings. That's going to pop this up right here. Specifically, if you are not on the Advanced tab to begin with, if you're somewhere over here, go to the Advanced tab, and now near the bottom, you're going to see an Environment Variables button. Click that, and it's going to bring up the Environment Variables Configuration screen. Now, the specific one that we're interested in is the Path variable. These are system variables and these are user variables. I'm going to double click on this path variable. And as you can see, we've got Python 3.6, 3.2 added to the path, which means every time I run a program that resides in one of these paths, Windows is going to know where to look for it because it's going to check all these paths first and then all these paths and that one. And then if it doesn't find it, then it's going to say, okay, well, I don't really know what you're looking for. And that's why we add paths to the path variable. So that has been added. If I open up command prompt here, you will see that if I run Python, it's going to successfully find it and run the program. Now that is because I have it installed to that path. Up here you can see users, my user, app data, local, etc., etc. And as you can see right here, that is the path that was added. So every time I run Python, this is one of the first paths it checks, and it goes, well, do I have a Python exe file? And it does. Now you can also run all of the programs from the scripts directory, including pip. And so that's what we're going to talk about right now. Let me exit out of here. So pip, basically, for example, if you wanted to build a web scraper or a web crawler, and if you just wanted to have a program that would download certain pages, what you would have to do is build a scraper, and In PHP, for example, you have access to curl right for, like, it's shipped with curl. There's no default requests library for Python, so you'll have to install one. And it's most usually you're going to be using some type of framework or library within Python, just because it doesn't make sense to continue rewriting things that other people already have. So you're going to be doing a lot of this, so I recommend getting used to it. We're going to go ahead and install a package that we're going to be using for web scraping, and that is called requests. So what you need to do is type pip install and then the name of the package you want to install. Now, this is the problem I was getting before, so I guess a reinstallation did not fix the problem, and I have no idea what the problem is. I've been reading this Stack Overflow thread, and so far I haven't discovered what the problem is, but there are a few workarounds. So, number one, probably the one we're going to go with is, since you can run Python from the command line, because that's been added to the path, you can actually work around this by typing python-m pip install requests. And I've already got installed, so it's just going to say requirement already satisfied, but it should install for you guys. So anytime you see me in this course type pip install anything, all you Windows guys, remember, use python-m pip install and then whatever you're going to install. So that is how you install things with pip. And now, once we've got this installed, if I were to jump back into Python, you can just import the library that you just created. And now you have access to that class. And that is how to get set up with this stuff on Windows. I hope you guys enjoy this course. I'm definitely going to.